Many of us enjoy a morning cup of Joe, but few enjoy it more than Dwayne Schmidt. It's a moment of stillness, a pleasure he thought was gone forever.
It impeded on everything, buttoning shirts, jackets, shaving. I would nick myself with a blade. Using the computer, my fingers would shake.
Schmidt is one of an estimated 10 million people in the United States who live with an essential tremor, the most common movement disorder in the world.
This is an essential tremor. The hand shakes in an up and down motion. It's something hereditary, as I understand it. My grandfather had it.
For the 79-year-old from Rhode Island, this was more than an inconvenience. He still works as an accountant, and numbers were now a problem.
I could no longer write. Numbers got sloppy. Then I was printing with two hands, using the left hand to steady it. Last year, I was writing down numbers and would misread them the following day.
After several failed attempts to control his body with medication, his doctor recommended a fairly new treatment, showing remarkable results.
They're looking at their hand and they're saying, wait a sec, it's not moving. And then they get this big smile on their face. You know, it's really remarkable.
Brigham and Women's Hospital is the only facility in New England currently performing what's called focused ultrasound therapy, led by Dr. Reese Cosgrove, a neurosurgeon who specializes in the surgical treatment of epilepsy.
Wiggle your fingers.
For 40 years, he has been helping people control their involuntary body movements. The only option had been invasive surgery.
The original procedure was what we call radiofrequency thalamotomy. You have to make a little incision in the head, drill a hole in the skull. Then we transitioned in the mid-90s to deep brain stimulation. It's a two-stage operation, both with general anesthesia. We're instrumenting the brain, pretty involved.
Now every Tuesday, you can find Dr. Cosgrove here, performing a two-hour day surgery without ever creating an incision.
It's just so remarkable that we can do this operation without ever opening up the person's head. While we're doing it, they're in the MRI scanner. While we're treating them, we're also imaging their brain while we're doing it. So we can see the lesion being made as we make it. I mean, that's never happened before. Without any holes in the head, so there's no risk of bleeding or hemorrhage or infection.
The process begins by shaving the head. Then the patient is fitted inside a helmet of sorts.
Inside this helmet, there are over 1,000 little focused ultrasound transmitters embedded in the sphere, and they're all pointing at the focal point.
Then into the MRI, Cosgrove in another room controlling this surgery from a computer screen.
The procedure actually creates a permanent lesion in a very specific nucleus in the thalamus. This is a target in the thalamus that we've known for many, many years is the source of the tremor.
The lesion is created in small increments. In between, neurological tests. These are images of Schmidt's brain after the procedure.
Right here in the thalamus is the lesion we created.
A pea-sized lesion that killed the neurons responsible for the tremor. This is video of Schmidt before and after his procedure. The results are immediate, and so far, long-lasting.
As soon as we make the lesion and make it an appropriate size, large enough, the tremor stops.
Are there any limitations?
It's not perfect. I tell the patients, you don't get hands like mine, okay? The concept is when somebody has a really bad tremor and they can't drink from a cup, or they can't write, they can't feed themselves, then that's disabling.
Schmidt's surgery was in early August of 2020, several weeks later.
You can see the left hand shaking up and down. The right hand is perfectly steady.
And both hands used to shake just like that?
Just the same way.
As of right now, doctors are only able to perform the procedure on one side of the body, giving patients back stability in their dominant side, which for many is more than enough.
I was painting trim on the house yesterday, and I was able to get a nice line. I can do a crossword puzzle now, because I can get the letters inside the little boxes and read them.
So a pea-sized lesion can change somebody's life.
That's correct.
Lo and behold, I could draw a spiral. I hadn't been able to draw a spiral in years.
Not only are the results for essential tremor remarkable, researchers are hopeful the surgery will be successful for such conditions as Parkinson's disease. They are also studying whether this type of procedure could be an effective way to treat brain tumors. Next, sometimes even the best ideas get this reaction.
Yeah, I knew he was crazy, but that's what was so exciting about it.